This is the 10th part of the tutorial series where we make a low-poly vehicle for Unreal Engine 4. Link in the description to see the result of the completed tutorial series. Also, this tutorial is available in written format. Link to it into the description. Import speedometers and tachometers textures into an Unreal Engine project. Open the current speedometer's material and make the following changes to it. Make a material instance from just changed speedometer's material. In the newly created material instance, change the background face texture to the tachometer 1. By changing scalar parameter values, we can see that we can change the pointer rotation and material emission. These values will be used in the vehicle's blueprint to drive the speedometer and tachometer. Change the vehicle's tachometer material to the just made material instance. If you have set everything correctly, then the speedometer and tachometer materials should look like this. Delete the old tachometer material. Duplicate the speedometer's material. Open duplicated material and change its material domain to user interface. Remove the emission parameter from it and change material blend mode to masked. Connect face texture's alpha channel with the material's opacity mask input. Make a material instance from the duplicated speedometer's material. In the newly created material instance, change the background face texture to the tachometer 1. Make a new folder for the UI elements and create a new widget blueprint into it. In the widget blueprint, add two image elements to the canvas panel. Change both image details like shown in the video. Make a function that will be responsible for updating values for the UI speedometer and tachometer. Open the vehicle blueprint. In the construction script, create dynamic material instances for speedometer and tachometer materials and promote them as variables in the vehicle blueprint. At the event begin play, create the widget we previously made, promote it as a variable, and then add it to the viewport. Make a function that will update speedometer and tachometer values. Hook up the new function to the tick event. Find the place where vehicle lights are turned on and off, and add functionality to it to turn on and off speedometers and tachometers backlight. Bind input which we will use for switching between cameras. Add another camera to the vehicle's mesh. Fix the newly added camera's placement and disable its auto-activation, and adjust its field of view for your preference. Add functionality for switching between cameras. Edit camera's look around functionality so it would be possible to look around with both cameras. Now speedometer, tachometer, and first-person camera are set up for the vehicle. Make sure to like and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this.